Welcome to another tutorial on MATLAB. In this tutorial, we will see what is the workflow that we are going to be following in the code generation implementation. So the code generation implementation or the model-based design that we have is including first the development of the requirement document. This requirement document includes the description of what we are going to be designing, and with the help of this document, we can verify the individual stages, whether those are behaving properly or not. So this is the base for whatever the design that we have. Once we have the requirement document ready or the design description report ready, like, we need to start the model-based development. Based on this requirement document, the model is being developed. The model-based development is done in MATLAB Simulink environment. Once the model is being developed, it is being tested. At this stage, the testing is called a model-based testing or a model-in-loop testing. So, as the name suggests, the model-in-loop testing can be implemented in the model or the MATLAB model, and suppose there is a bug found in the particular software or particular model, then that will be fixed again, and then it will be going to the mill testing again. So like this, at the model level, all the bugs are being fixed. And once there is a confidence on the model that we have developed, which is based on the requirement document, then we go for the code generation. The code generation that we have is directly auto-generated from the model, and once we have the code, again we need to verify whether the behavior of the code is matching to the model behavior, and also it should match to the requirement document. The requirement document describes the complete behavior of the software that we are going to be developing. So once we verify, like, our code is generated properly or it is behaving properly, and this verification is being done in a SIL testing. SIL testing means software in loop testing. So in this software in loop testing, we verify the code that is being generated from the model, and once we have the confidence on the software that is being generated or the code that is being generated, then we directly implement it into any hardware, which could be any controller. It could be a flight controller, or it could be a controller that is used in any medical devices. So this is how the entire workflow looks like. We will see how we are going to implement this particular workflow in the further tutorials. In case you are liking the channel, please consider subscribing and stay updated to the channel so that you will not miss any valuable content. So happy learning, MATLAB. Stay connected.